something that a lot of jiu-jitsu guys envy a lot is when guys were able, like yourself, to start wrestling earlier in life. A lot of jiu-jitsu guys, they get into jiu-jitsu and it's kind of their first foray into grappling. And a lot of times they'll run into a wrestler on the mats and be like, damn, dude, I should have wrestled in school, man. Like, that would have been so valuable now. For people out there that are pure jiu-jitsu guys who don't have a lot of takedown experience or wrestling experience, what do you think are some of the most important drills or things that they can do to help develop a good blueprint for the stand-up portion of grappling?
I mean, first off, just starting your feet a lot. You get these guys, they always start on their knees. You're not going to get wrestling if you're starting your knees every match. So starting your feet a lot and then try to get wrestlers to do it. You know, find wrestlers that want to go takedowns and you'll pick it up quick. I'm really surprised at how well jiu-jitsu guys can learn wrestling. Once you have good body movement and understand grappling, it's not that big of a transfer to go from ground to feet. Just as good wrestlers can go down and learn jiu-jitsu. As long as you're open-minded and want to learn it. The problem is you get people that don't want to learn it. You get wrestlers that don't want to go down and actually learn jiu-jitsu. They just want to take you down and hold you. And then you get jiu-jitsu guys that don't want to actually learn wrestling. They're like, that's like too much work. They'd rather just sit to their guard. But if they decide they want to learn takedowns, they already know one. It's pretty easy to learn the other. So I'd say just actually do the takedowns. And ideally, if you have a good wrestler to work with, grab him and have him show you techniques. You know, if you don't have that, you can watch it. I mean, with YouTube instructional videos, there's so many ways you can find techniques nowadays. So you either get instructionals or watch YouTube videos or find a good wrestler. So it's if you want to learn the skill, there's no way. You're lucky you can now. When I was coming up, there was like one or two instructional videos. There wasn't much stuff on YouTube. Well, YouTube don't even existed. So you'd have to watch fights where you could get them. It wasn't easy, but with all the knowledge out there today, you can actually learn it without good coaching. Obviously, ideally, you're going to have the good coaches, but if you don't, there's just stuff out there everywhere online now.
Yeah, kids, young folks today getting into the sport, man, they don't know how good they have it, I think. There's all this just accessibility. And I remember like when I first started training jiu-jitsu, like it was hard to even find, and I lived in a pretty big city. It was even hard early on to find like more than a couple schools. And then I know that if you go further out the city, man, you'd have to travel a long way. Some guys would drive like an hour and a half each way just to get to class every day. Nowadays, man, there's schools. Yeah, they're everywhere, you know?
Yeah, I had to drive an hour, you know, to go train to the Gracies because I was, you know, like, well, that was the best place to train jiu-jitsu. There's a couple places in San Francisco, but me wanting to be the best, I moved to San Francisco and I was an hour drive every day to go train, but it was just something I did because I was wanting to be the best.